Our next speaker is Ryan Furness with Nearest You, and let's kick it off with a standing ovation for our next speaker, Ryan.
Thanks, Patrick. This is a fun one. I'm also on this side of town. I'm in Richfield, but I've been to several 1 million Cups, but this is my first here, so I should also get a mug for that. I get double mugs today, filled with coffee, hopefully. But I used to go to the St. Paul one more frequently. I don't go down to St. Paul all that much, so it's hard to get down there. I also work in Rochester. I'm a faculty member at the University of Minnesota, Rochester. For those of you who didn't know, that's my day job, as it were. I teach the Spanish for health sciences, so medical Spanish for the students. The degree down in the University of Minnesota Rochester is health science specific. But on the side, and primarily in the summer and over the breaks, I focus on startups. And I have two businesses besides this Nearest You. One is called No Ordinary Journey. It's an apparel manufacturing company based in Minneapolis here. We do for motorcycles and other people, but Nearest You is why I'm here today, and I think that's the problem that we started to solve 3 years ago with a co-founder who's no longer a co-founder but is a consultant with us still, is how do we support local products? How do we answer this question of where can I find a local craft product near me, wherever I am? And when we try as consumers, we were really struggling with going to websites. I'm sure you've all been on a certain website for a company and you're like, where can I find this product? They have a crappy little map embed. On a mobile device especially, you're pinching and you're squeezing and you're pressing this little, you know, orange dot. Oh, there's like 500 little orange dots. And and if you're on an iPhone especially, it's really challenging because everything is based on Google and Google Maps. So I don't have a slide to show you this, but you know, as an example, you can click on that and you'll be taken into a browser experience on your Safari iOS, and it will give you a text-based turn-by-turn. Go up, half a mile, turn right. I mean, when you're driving, when you're on your bike, when you're walking, what a pain in the butt that is. And so we set out to solve this problem, to help make a better store locator for food and beverage brands, especially craft, but we're starting to get a little bigger than that because brands are contacting us and they're bigger than, say, just the local craft brand that's distributed in Minnesota. So I started 3 years ago with this crazy idea, and we started down a road, a path of coffee, and it proved really, really challenging. One, because people aren't that loyal. Like, yeah, we love our Starbucks or our Caribou or whatever, but going out of my way 3 miles to get Peace Coffee doesn't always happen. Going out of my way to get, you know, Dunbar, whatever. But so a lot of people, we just realized early on that a coffee finder was not really what we wanted to build. And I knew beer and spirits were going to be where it was at. So it took us a couple of years to kind of figure that out, figure out the technology. We originally outsourced everything, which I'd love to tell that tale someday as well. It was really, really hard. We had done in India, and I felt like we got a little screwed by some of that. And that was our own inability to know what was good and what was not, and what we really wanted as a final product. But ultimately, we brought it all back, and we have essentially an acting CTO that now works with us, great guy, Peter Kerwin. And so he and I have kind of pushed this thing to the next level. We relaunched in September of 2017. So what we do then is we build this technology, these store locators for companies. We embed that technology on their website. And additionally, we also aggregate all of those store locators from all of those brands onto a single website, nearestyou.com. So you as a consumer can actually go to Nearest You, and you can all do it right now. Go to Nearest You and search for local products. Now, we don't have everyone, of course. It's only the clients that we work with. But you can click on, for example, beer. So really, we're working for that holy grail, right? The ultimate craft beer finder. Harder than it looks. But certainly, so you can click on beer, and you're shown the brands that are nearest to you that are sold or served in any location. So we get that data from the brands themselves or the distributors. So we get their distribution reports, or we get the information from the brands. So we can actually do that managing and updating for them. And just speaking to automation, we're working on that right now because we get a lot of data from all of the brands that work with us. They keep sending in monthly reports. So we're trying to automate that with our API for Foursquare. So we use Foursquare's API location data, not Google's. Doesn't matter really, but that's what we went with. So that's what we do. Now, we've essentially become a website for search and discovery of craft food and beverage brands. And we have about, I think we're over 60 now. We just signed on Social Cider yesterday, so that was fun. What happened here?
It says I should contact you.
You should, please do. Yeah, I don't know why beer isn't working. You can probably search for the brand though. So if you search for Fair State, hopefully that will work. If you've got your location services on.
I set for the zip code.
Oh, that was a zip search? Yeah, zip search. I hate zip search. Not for only for this reason, but it's a terrible, who knows their zip code, right?
Yeah.
So now it works.
That's what pops up first. So
good, I'm glad it works, at least there. Yeah. But zip code was something I wanted to leave off altogether. I hate zip code because you only know it at home and in your workplace, right? A mobile user never knows their zip code, but almost every map out there, every technology asks for your zip code. It's like, I don't know it. If I'm traveling, I don't know it. We have brands in 9 states now that use our platform. So when you're traveling to another country, another state like Maryland or something, you'll find some breweries and some distilleries that are there and that are available in those regions. We signed on some national brands, Schilling Cider out of Washington. But you're able to see that they're also available here. So if you click on what we will add as a cider category, you'll see that. But I think we've hit 6 minutes, Patrick. So the technology works. We charge the brands by the number of locations they have. So smaller brands pay less than larger brands. But that's really the platform that we're pushing now, and we're signing on brands pretty much weekly these days. So
give a round of applause.